7 News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Chief Meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
Snow today has been kind of like this winter, just hanging around, not really doing a whole lot, though. You can see most of the solid area on the radar is eastern sections. It's getting patchier as we go off to the west, but temperatures, yeah, right around that freezing point. Like I talked about yesterday, the March sun angles are a little higher. It's harder to get things to stick. Most of it's been on the grassy areas. Roads are just generally wet. But, you know, be careful as you're heading out this evening. These temperatures aren't going to go up much. If anything, they're going to come down. Yeah, you could get some slick spots out there. But this is part of the main storm. But you can see this whole area. But you watch how it's just kind of shrinking from west to east. And I think it'll continue as energy gets shifted toward the coast. Look at the precipitation picking up over the Delmarva, South Jersey. They could get a couple more inches of snow. There's also this little band out here out in the Ohio Valley. It just went through Columbus heading toward Cleveland and then Pittsburgh in the next few hours. It's kind of like a line of showers, but it's snow. It's a cold front that's heading in our direction. So the main storm is still well off the coast. This is the area that's low pressure that's been giving us some light snow today. But that's going to combine, and they're going to probably be off the Delmarva as we get into the overnight hours, then shoot up toward Nova Scotia. I'll tell you, they could have snow and hurricane force winds up into Nova Scotia. But we'll watch this front come through later on this evening. And I think around midnight or so, it could bring a few more snow showers. Could even whiten the ground a little bit. You can see the square in Gettysburg, a little bit of a coating of snow out there. Just kind of damp and miserable. And that's the way we see it for the evening hours. We'll see the snow showers continuing, but mainly in the eastern sections. Very light. And I think they're going to let up over the next few hours. And we'll start dropping back below the freezing point. So again, watch for a few slick spots, but it shouldn't be a widespread problem. A few more snow showers come through. I'm thinking right around or shortly after midnight. And then I think they'll get out of here. Breaks will develop in the clouds. It's becoming windy overnight. As the winds pick up, the temperatures drop. And I'll tell you, tomorrow morning, it's going to feel like single digits out there. With sunshine, it's going to be a windy, cold day all day long. It is not going to be very nice. Here's the snow I was talking about, and that's going to start to wind down the next few hours. We'll get a little break, but then here comes that next batch. I think, again, just a line of showers or snow showers, then it gets out of here. We start clearing out overnight, and we have plenty of sunshine on tap for tomorrow. Not the temperatures, but just the temperatures and the wind combined. I'll tell you, that is really going to make it feel cold. Wind chill's not a problem this evening, but then they start really dropping down toward the single digits by morning. And all day long tomorrow, I think they're pretty much in the teens out there. So a couple of cold days coming our way. 30s, we get back into the 40s, a little breezy, a little cool, though, on Thursday. Then Friday, a chance of some showers coming in, and it looks like some more showers may come back in again on Saturday before we break out in a little more sunshine. But you see those 50s. On that 7 day. That looks good. Cohen Clark from Palmyra, congratulations. There's our kids' art for tonight. Nice rainbow there, or maybe on a night like tonight, a snowbow, if you would. Thank you, Cohen. Cohen's first grader from Palmyra. Stanley Sikowski from Pine Grove. Stanley is our Weather Watcher Umbrella winner from the Whitaker Center and WGAL. Congratulations to him.